Ne ierte pentru mica încurcătură.
Nu este nicio problemă.
Știu că în armată totul e riguros, dar aici la noi se mai... Și vă ascultăm cu plăcere. Și interes.
Oare se vede prezentarea?
Da.
Da, da. E regulă? Bun. Să începem. Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, it's a great honor to meet you today. Our team comprises Ionescu, Sandu, and Mihaiu, who is unable to present today. My name is Teodor Georgică, and we are representing the Land Forces Academy Nicolae Bălcescu from Sibiu under the guidance of Associate Professor PhD Ana Maria Sârbu. We are privileged to present our proposed project entitled AR Enhanced Video Streaming with Object Detection Capabilities designed for a versatile UAV platform. We'll commence by outlining the context and motivation for our project, which are rooted in the significant advancements in electronics, evolving from simple transistors to powerful processors and specialized controllers such as the one we utilized. Additionally, human-machine interaction and augmented reality are domains that are profoundly transforming our current era. Therefore, we have proposed a quadcopter augmented with several contemporary functionalities and integrated a simple deep learning algorithm. I now invite my colleague to present the primary components employed in our project.
Thank you. When making the drone, we used the three major categories of components: the radio system, electronics, and powertrain. Let's start with the radio system. The radio system consists of FlySky FS-EA6 transmitter, which allows us to control the drone up to a distance of 1,200 meters. The transmitter sends the signals through the pulse position modulation, PPM protocol, to the 2.4 gigahertz receiver, which decodes the signal using the pulse width modulation. Electronic part. We used the Arduino Pilot module 2.8, which includes a processor running at 16 megahertz, a 3-axis gyroscope, an accelerometer, and a barometer, similar to the famous NPU 6050 used in electronics. It also have numerous analog input pins. Also, we used the 30 amperes electronic speed controllers positioned between the power distribution board and the circuit. The electronic speed controllers translate the signal generated by the APM 2.8 into rotational power, a common engine language. On the powertrain, we have the motors, the propellers, the frame, and the 4S LiPo battery. And now let's talk about the assembly steps. We started by soldering the electronic speed controllers to the power distribution board, then added the frame arms on top. Then we plugged into a power source to check the connections and tested the circuit using generalized microcontrollers, starting by supplying a variable voltage using a potentiometer, followed by supplying a DC voltage to the four motors.
So in the final phase, we connected the receiver. Let's see the video first. Okay, so as it's shown, in the final phase, we connected the receiver and the remote control and checked the correct operation of the system. The receiver and the GPS were connected to the APM 2.8 configured in the mission planner application, as you can see on the screen. And we entered the necessary parameters, perform sensor calibration and radio calibration, and set the flight modes for the mission. Then we tested the drone both internally and externally. And now I will invite my colleague to speak about the analysis.
The project is segmented into two principal phases, which involves the study of the circuit, the the analysis, which involves the study of the circuit and the synthesis, where we implement improvements. During the analysis phase, we identify three protocols predominantly used in our project: pulse width modulation, pulse position modulation, and integrated to circuit. The operational framework of the circuit involves transmitting a PPM encoded signal from the operator to the receiver, which then interprets and converts it into a pulse width modulation protocol across six channels. This signal is conveyed to the controller, which interprets it and correlates it with data from motion sensors, subsequently sending commands to the electronic speed controllers by the pulse width modulation protocol to adjust motor speed accordingly. Within the synthesis phase, we have implemented live image transmission through various methods. One approach utilizes a Raspberry Pi 4 coupled with a high-quality camera, transmitting high-quality live images over local area network with a latency of 2 seconds. As you can see in the image, the image is clear and stable. And the image was put on the table. A Python script has been developed to capture screenshots every 2 seconds, save them to a directory, and execute a MATLAB algorithm utilizing the pre-trained AlexNet library for object detection and classification. The identified objects are automatically stored in the text file, recording the object's name, position within the image, and the detection time step. As we can see in the image, we have the detection and the TXT file. Another transmission method involves using an ESP32 CAM program to establish a web server and transmit images to it. By accessing the server link with the AR glasses, HoloLens 2 in our case, the images are projected onto the glasses, providing an augmented reality experience, highly advantageous in military contexts. Moreover, a GoPro Hero 7 camera is employed to capture ultra-high quality images with a wide-angle lens and advanced image stabilization. These images can be transmitted live on platforms such as Twitch with a latency of 2 seconds or saved to an external storage card. I now invite my colleague to present additional functionalities, including analog transmission and object deployment.
So firstly, I'll talk about the FPV camera setup. This set of electronic devices allowed us to transmit images in real time from the drone. It consists of a CMOS 1200 camera with the 2.8 camera lens, often used in RC projects, connected to AWRF transmitter. This is a transmitter with a power of 600 milliwatts. So this setup can transmit the live image on 40 channels around a frequency of 5.8 gigahertz. The recent armed conflicts have shown us the importance of drone in the battlefield. As you may see, drones are very important when launching or transporting explosive devices from an height. So that's why we wanted to implement such a device in our system using a SG90 servo motor, as you can see in the video, connected to the drone receiver. By achieving a potentiometer on the remote, the pilot can control the servo. The next one. Okay, so additionally, we have also explored the connection of a camera to a Raspberry Pi microcontroller that can transmit live web feeds through a simple internet connection, as my colleague said earlier. We also studied the implementation of the Hacker RF1. It's a gadget in which we can change the transmission. We can use frequency hop, and that's the connection between the remote and the drone will be more stable and hard to jam.
Thank you. So in the end, we can say that it was developed low cost with high versatility quadcopter that has extended control range, basic object detection algorithm, and a great platform for future enhancements. The contribution is about the integration of many modules to form an up and working system and the synthesis of the circuit by real-time object detection along with many perspectives. All the process steps, files and trails parts were highlighted. As the final result, we have a project that stands as a promising candidate to evolve into a tactical operator assistant equipped with intelligent algorithms and ample opportunities for further development. Thank you for the attention paid up to the end, and we would greatly appreciate your critics, questions, and feedback as they contribute significantly to the Scholarity Dialogue.
Thank you for the presentation. I think we have a question.
Da, o să vorbesc în română, dacă nu vă deranjează. Ați vorbit acolo de recunoașterea unor...
If you have any questions, it would be great to discuss with you.
Can I put question in Romanian?
Did you say, scuze, a zis ceva, am avut sonor oprit.
Da, ziceam că o să pun întrebarea în limba română.
Da.
Ați vorbit despre recunoașterea unor obiecte, ați implementat deja și partea aceasta sau ați făcut drona, ne-ați prezentat construcția dronei, dar ați lucrat și pe partea de recunoașterea de imagini, de algoritmi de inteligență artificială pentru recunoașterea imaginilor?
Deci este implementat pe drona noastră, dar este încă în stare incipient studiu, astfel că de aceea am folosit un model preantrenat, adică pur și simplu l-am importat în MATLAB și el și-a făcut treaba. Nu l-am antrenat noi pentru anumite obiecte, încă acest studiu este la început.
Bine, vă mulțumesc.
Și ne mulțumim.
Mulțumim și noi. Dacă nu mai sunt alte întrebări, o să ne întoarcem din nou la probleme de restaurare. Să invit pe domnișoara cu...